Hello everybody and welcome to my Hero Editor Guide. So finally I'm getting around to actually doing a guide for this. On the internet there are also a written guide, and I just want to say that that guide was really well made and it's in the description below. So if you want to have a written guide instead, this one here, then you should check out the description, just because, you know, some people like a written guide instead of a video guide. That's fine. So his link is gonna be in the description below, just because it also really helped me out a lot. So yeah, that was just a little introduction there. Let's talk item packs first. So making items in Hero Editor is a complete mess. It's just very hard and I don't really understand how to do it and so forth. But luckily good people have made item packs instead. I'm just going to go into the game now with a prepared character here, and then you can see the sort of item that I got through the item pack that I have also in the description below. You can download that link as well. It's virus free. I just checked it with malware antibytes. Everything, it's cool, it's a media fire link, it's not a virus or anything, but I just wanted to say that so we kind of get that out of the way. But yeah, this is the item that I made in like half a minute. Very fun to kind of just see an ethereal Archon plate fully perfect. So yeah, oh, and it misses just a little bit of durability, but whatever. So yeah, that is the end goal of this guide, to make you able to make such an item here in less than half a minute. So let's go for it. So yeah, I talked about the item packs. This is the first link. Again, it's in the description below that you need to get. So you download this one, you extract it with WinRAR, whatever you use, and then you're pretty much ready. Also, you need to obviously have Hero Editor downloaded already, but I'm not gonna discuss how to do that. You just Google this, and oh, then you go into whatever link you want, maybe just the top ones or whatever. It's up to yourself. It doesn't really matter, but you know, some people might prefer safer links that I have shown them so far. But yeah, I just wanted to again talk a little about both written guides and the item packs that you need to get to kind of get it set up. So with that out of the way, let's move on to what you actually need to do when everything is done. Or install it, download it even. You wanna open up Hero Editor, so this is the start page. Then you wanna go into open, so you click the little open tab here. Then you wanna navigate to where your item packs are. So in my case, this is on my desktop. I'm already inside of the folder right now, but yeah, this was just an example. In the item pack, there are also unskilled level 90 characters. You don't really need this, but still it's fine to work with. So as soon as you do this assassin here, you click on the assassin, you got a level 99 assassins with noble stats, nothing really weird, just completed all the quests, I think. No, he hasn't really done too much, but yeah, whatever. You can always check that later. The program is not that hard to do with. But then the assassin here is ready to be made. And the only thing you really need to do now, once the character is ready, you need to go down here and say import item from file. And then you need to navigate again to where your item packs are. So again, we go into the item pack here, and then we can take, let's find a charm. Let's find a grand charm. Okay, so we got a 10 max, 75 area, 45 life. Now, spoiler a little bit, you can't really get all the items in the item pack here. Again, this was done freely by some dude maybe many years ago. I'm not really sure if there's gonna be item packs that are better than this one that I found, but I just want to highlight that it doesn't really have all items, but still it covers the, you know, a decent amount, so you can still test out builds pretty good. So this is the item that I now currently have, but in order to make this work, so you also have this save file in the game, you need to go into we need to go into save, and that's pretty much it. I can just quickly cut it here before I figure out that. Right, stupid me. Of course, when you're in the folder for the item packs, you're just gonna find the file that's already been made with a level 99 character. You hit copy. And then you navigate to the save folder of Diablo 2. Now, a note here, InPatch 1.30, well, pretty much back since the launch in 2001, whatever, save folder for all offline single player characters was always in the installation folder. But since patch 1.40, Blizzard changed this for whatever the stupid reason they had. It was just an oversight, I suppose. They fucked something up. But it's found on C drive. It's found on users. So users, whatever your, you know, your username was when you named your computer. Then you go into the computer's name, and then you go into saved games, and then you go into Diablo 2, and that's it. And then you have all the save files for your character. Now, in my case, I hit it copy on this one, and then I just hit paste. And then we can open up the game actually right now. I actually think I don't even have to exit out of this one. Yeah. As you can see, this is the assassin character that I just saved into the folder. I didn't even have to log out of the game. Pretty sweet. Let's see if the grand charm that I made was on the character. And there you go, a perfect sharp grand charm of Vita. Let's do this really fast to end the video off with. I think I still had the assassin open. Yep. So I still have the file open, and as you can see now up here, a little note, please take notice of this. It says the location of the save file is now still in the on my desktop, but it should save correctly under the save folder of Diablo 2 now in saved games. I just think that's a little weird thing there, but yeah, let's do this. Import item from file. And let's take something else again. Let's just go find an item just so you can kind of see that works as well. Let's find something weird like, yeah, Haven's Breath. That's a fun one. Okay, the weapon there everyone always finds easily, the dragon one. So yeah, I think I can just hit save now. And let's see if I can even just do it while I've been logged into the character. I actually think you can do that. Okay, that didn't quite work, but yeah, this is pretty much it. Very easy to do once you understand how to use HeroEditor. Basic things, you can always change stuff like the level of the character, stats of the character, how many quests it's done, even change stuff like the mercy chance, so currently don't have a cube on the character, or a board. Yeah, mercy chant, so these are red right now, but if you buy them mercy chant, they should turn normal color. You can get all the waypoints, so in this case, since this save file has all the waypoints, I get them. Yeah, let's see what else we can just quickly mention. Yeah, skills, obviously, we can change all the skills, 20 in each, whatever you want. Quest. Just, this is kind of messy, but just kind of click around until you have all the quests completed. It's a little annoying to do this part here. Mercenary, again, you just buy whatever you want, choose the one you like. Pretty easy, that stuff. And introduction, this is just for making the NPCs stop talking to you, like they have a quest or whatever. And then we have also a little bit of a note here. It's just options, basically. Nothing really special there. And just some credits for the tutorial either or whatever. And yeah, I think that pretty much rounds it up. So before this gets too long, I hope this HeroEditor guide was useful to you. Because I looked on YouTube and there wasn't too many of these ones that were kind of made in a good way. Again, please check the description below. Also for the written guide that really did help me out. And as always, you can find all the needed download links in the description as well. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little guide for the HeroEditor. So, as always, have a good one,